Next up at UFC Vegas 40, we have the main event of the evening. We have Aspen Ladd versus Norma Dumont. Aspen Ladd, 9-1 overall, 4-1 in her last five. Norma Dumont, 6-1 overall, also 4-1 in her last five. And this is a fun matchup. This fight is at 145 pounds. 2 weeks ago, Aspen Ladd missed weight at 135 pounds. She had her period, which I know people are dragging her for that, but if you watched our breakdown video, I have coached wrestling for a very long time. I've coached females. I watched one of my wrestlers step on the scale at our gym. She had her period. Step on her scale at our gym was like a half a pound over or something like that. We got in the bus, chewing Skittles and spitting, right? Developed some saliva, spit it in the bottle, an hour, 2 hours, whatever the bus ride was, plus get on the scale at their gym. She gained a pound and a half, and it was our scale that we just brought from our gym to their gym. So I am not a lady doctor by any means, but I have seen with my own eyes what that could do to cutting weight. So I'm not going to drag her. Anyway, missed weight 2 weeks ago. She's now back up weight. Weight should not be an issue for this fight. And the only reason she got the opportunity is because Holly Holm dropped out. So it's a weird main event that, luckily Aspen was training for a fight just 2 weeks ago, so she'll be in shape. Norma was training for Holly Holm. That dropped, and she got herself an opponent. So it is an interesting matchup. Norma Dumont is very good on her feet. Very good on her feet. She's very relaxed, very comfortable. Her striking is super technical. She has a 100% takedown defense, at least as of now. If you look at her strike differential, she lands about five strikes and takes less than three in return, which is very solid. If you compare that to Aspen, who is a bit wild, she essentially takes one to give one. So Aspen hits you, gets hit. Norma Dumont hits you five times, only gets hit three. And obviously, that's the stat that you would rather have under your belt. Norma's also got solid grappling. Her takedowns are not great, but if she does get to the ground, she is more than capable. Aspen Ladd, we broke her down a few times because her fights keep getting booked, rebooked, booked, rebooked. But she still has not fought in 2 years. It is a two-year layoff. She does get wild. She's just tough and gritty and crazy and just willing to win that fight at any all costs. So she's not very technical, but again, super tough. And she is decent everywhere. She has zero quit in her whatsoever. And you could always count on her to bring the fight. This layoff was because she tore her ACL and her MCL, and it took her a full 2 years to fully recover from that and get some fights booked, and then a couple fights canceled for a few different reasons. And hopefully she will actually make the walk on this Saturday. Her one loss is because of a bad weight cut. Bad weight cut, wasn't fully there. The weight cut won't be an issue here, but what is interesting about that one loss, and we told this story before, is she vetoed it with the commission, saying this is an early stoppage, and challenged the commission. The commission heard the case and said, yeah, we should vote on this. And she lost the vote, but it was 3-2, which means there were two people on that commission that said, you know what? I do think that was an early stoppage, and I would be willing to overturn that. So that is really interesting. You do not see that very often. So you could argue that Aspen is 9-0-1. Either way, wild, tough, will do anything she has to do to win. And weight should not be a factor in this fight. Therefore, cardio exhaustion, and none of that should be a factor. I do like Norma in this fight, though. Norma is my pick. I've been very high on Aspen in the past, but this is a different fight than those fights. Norma's a killer on her feet. She has great takedown defense. She will likely pick apart Aspen and then defend whatever takedown come her way after winning the exchanges on her feet. I expect her to be much bigger. Aspen's coming up in weight. She's not small. You know, she was already big, but she is coming up in weight. And I expect Norma to be super composed. So while Aspen will get wild and seemingly more wild as the fight goes on, Norma will stay composed, pick her apart, outstrike her, outtouch her, frustrate Aspen with the striking, and then frustrate her even more when she defends the takedowns. You know, the size, the technique, the long layoff for Aspen, it's a great recipe for Norma to dominate this fight, put her name out there. I don't think she's as recognizable as she should be. I think a lot of people, and that's the recognizable. You get my point. I don't think enough people really appreciate how good Norma Dumont is. You know, Aspen's got zero quit whatsoever, and that's a bit concerning here. But I do like Norma in this fight quite a bit. I already have a money line bet on Norma. I'll take that all day. I did have an over on the round bet because they messed up and they initially opened the round at 2.5, the round line at 2.5. So I hit that over immediately. I'm like, oh yeah, this is going to go way past 2.5 rounds. And then they canceled my bet. I said, what the hell? I refreshed. And now the round line is 4.5 rounds. And I'm not going to do the over on that. So, because then if I was positive, then I would just do Norma wins by decision, but I'm not positive. So anyway, money line on Norma Dumont. I like that very much. If that line keeps moving, I got her at, I think, even money, and it's already starting to move up, meaning I think she was like plus 110 or something like that earlier today. So I'm going to check the books. This is a fight where you might want to bounce between books and see where you can get a little bit better odds, because a lot of people are on Aspen, and I think Norma's just not getting the respect she deserves. I think she should win. I think it should be pretty straightforward for her. And I've got a money line bet on her. I may double down on that. If the line moves, I will most likely hit it again. We on picks.com/bets. We have three different betting partners. Jump into all three of them. They have promos, deposit matches for all of them. Jump into all three. Find the best odds. Find the best prop that you like and play them all. There's no reason you should have all your eggs in one sportsbook basket. They all have different odds. They all have different pros and cons. They all have different bets, parlay abilities, etc. Jump in, spread the wealth, and make it happen. Norma Dumont will be in my DraftKings lineup. The Monkey Knife fight line, I don't know what I'm doing with that. Aspen's is just so freaking high. So I don't know what I'm going to do with that. So I'm not going to touch it. I'm not going to give you any advice there because I don't want to be held accountable for that. But I do like Norma. I will be betting on her. Thank you very, very much for the watch. And do all the things. Like, subscribe, share. Thank you very much. I'll see you on Saturday.